Hey guys, welcome. This morning I've got a very, very special video for you all. Let's very quickly get the cat out of the bag. It is 4 a.m. Okay? Sorry. ASMR mode. But no. It's 4 a.m. I can't sleep. I've struggled to sleep. I have lots of reasons behind it. I'm not getting into it. I'm not here to talk about all of my stuff that's going on with me. We're here to talk about influencer boxing. As you can read by the title, Anthony Taylor's turn to get put under the deep dive. Or put into the deep dive. I don't really want to say too much. Want to jump straight into it in a minute. But yeah. I can't find any footage. It's so hard to find footage of these guys just working out. Because I can't use clips of fights. I'm going to try and use media workout for KSI versus Joe Fournier. Hopefully it allows me to use that. If not, I don't know. These videos recently have just been shithoused. I'm sorry. I know a lot of people, I keep getting comments saying I love this and all that, and I respect all of you, and thank you so much for enjoying. I don't know if these videos are any good or if they're boring or, you know. So it's good to know people are actually enjoying it. So I'm going to keep up the content. I'm trying to think of how many I can upload, because I want to go in order of the fight card that's on Tapology, because I don't have the official running order anywhere. I think they posted it, but I just can't seem to get it, which is fine, it's all good. But I'm going in my order of fights that I believe would be at the top and all that. So yeah, we're at Anthony Taylor versus King Kenny. So you got two videos coming out today. Hopefully one is out this one will probably come out around 8 o'clock. I'm probably gonna release this in about 4 hours, and then about 3 p.m. I mean, I can upload these whenever, like, they're gonna be recorded already, edited, ready, but I just want to make sure that the algorithm pushes it out to the people. I want to make sure that my skill level is smart enough so that people can see it and you guys can enjoy it. Sorry, I really hope this does not sound awful. I hope I don't look too bad. I know it's very dark. I'm very sorry about that. But we've got some footage to go over. So let's get right into it before I continue waffling. Okay, let's get right into it. We've got AT right here. So this is how AT will be able to beat King Kenny. Or if he can, who knows? Remember, predictions out this Friday. It's coming Friday. I cannot wait. I have so many, like, with these videos, it's helping me understand who can actually win and who comes out on top. And I've actually changed a lot of my thoughts on the last two fights on who comes out on top drastically. Like, I'm all over the place. There's a few things I also want to go into in another video. So there might be three videos out today. One's coming out tonight then. There's been some things that happened last night that were just insane. Like Lee Wood, Bobby Green, UFC. If you didn't know, Lee Wood, pro boxer. So much has happened that I just want to get into. So, yeah. Vidal Riley's win. I haven't spoke about this on the channel, but Vidal Riley did win. I'd done it in the Logan Paul video, but they took it out because it was in a copyright section. So, it got taken out. But congrats to Vidal. I knew he could win. Didn't win the way I thought he would. But very, very impressed with what I saw there. You know, I can't go, oh, he didn't knock him out, I'm not impressed. Nah. Vidal did what he was meant to do. He went in there. He demolished the rounds. His opponent was just in there to survive at the end. I did say that would be kind of what happens. But still very, very good. I have not slept since you guys last saw me. I've recorded that video like 2 hours before it came out, which was the Wally Sharks video, and I haven't slept since. So it's been about 24 hours since I last slept. It's fine. Let's get into the video. Okay, so we got AT just with his coaches. We're gonna have to skip forward a bit. Sorry, Swarms. No disrespect. AT's talking to his coach. So AT's just moving about, you know, getting ready. I will probably do a reaction to I just realized you guys ain't getting audio. Hold on. It's because I haven't switched it. Let me just do that and then we'll be right back. There you go. There you go. I got the audio back, guys. So, you know, you're 18 moving around. I will probably do... I might do a stream if I can. I'm not sure if I will be able to. I might do a stream on their media workouts. I probably should be able to then because the media will be able to post it. So I'll probably do a stream on that to see what I say, what I see. You know, I might do a video breaking down each fight again on that. But it'll be like one long video. So it'll be about an hour long or something. But it'll be about the updated version of their media workouts, because obviously these are a bit old. So yeah, AT's moving around. One thing that's weird about AT is he sometimes closes his feet in and then moves them apart. So like he moves them like that. Sometimes he moves them like this. I'm trying to get in camera. Like that. Sometimes that. Sometimes that. Okay, let me explain the footwork. This is the longest distance. This obviously isn't the exact distance, but this is the longest distance. This is an MMA stance. This is a boxing one. Oh, sorry, just wiped the mic. This one is too close, and if you get caught being too close, it'll drop you. Now, AT, who did AT fight on this card? This wasn't the Salt Papi one, was it? This wasn't AT versus Salt Papi, was it? I think AT's last fight was against Salt Papi. It was meant to be against Paul Bamber on this one. But that didn't happen. So it might have been. It might have been. I might be wrong. So he's just moving around. Getting his footwork going. Stretching just to warm up a bit. You know. There you go. He's working on his guard here. In my opinion, the feet are a bit too close there. You know. Remember, this is just a workout, so obviously I shouldn't be too critical about it, but you know, you don't want to use anything like this in a fight, you know, because say if someone was here, they'd be hitting him right there because he's facing them. Yeah, that's good. He's keeping the hands up just to know where the level is, where he needs to keep them. So it's like that on his bike. See how he is on his bike, minding the gloves. This ain't too bad, but come on. We want to get into the real stuff. Sorry, Swarms. Is he putting on the gloves now? I think he's putting on the gloves. Yeah, he's putting on gloves. Hey, Vidal's there. Yeah, I respect Vidal a lot. I like Vidal. Alright, so if you see his working, here we go. It's good, but I want to see his feet as well, you know. He has his chin out as well, so he has it up. He has it up here. Oh, you guys can't really see much tonight. It's very dark. I would use my light, but I can't. It's a bit bright. But yeah, he has his chin up. Look at that. He's leaning in with that shot. I think he was going around, but because of the angle, it looked like he was leaning in. But, yeah, that's good. Catching the punches. That's good. Right. The way Anthony Taylor really fights is he's a bit of a dirty fighter. So what he does is he will blitz for a bit and then he'll clinch, hold, turn you around, fling you about a bit, get broken up, and then he'll go back to doing that. Kenny, my question is, if Kenny struggled against Ashley Raxu because of how Ashley Raxu was fighting and not because Kenny wasn't thrown. If it was because of how Ashley Raxu was fighting, AT's like that, but on a much higher scale. I feel like King Kenny will not be able to handle the pressure, you know. He won't be able to handle the clinching that. I think he's going to get annoyed with it. I feel like Anthony Taylor needs to make this fight a dirty fight for him to really come out on top, you know. Kenny has just got to keep his... I don't really want to talk too much about what Kenny's got to do. But if Anthony Taylor doesn't know how to get around the range, the height of Kenny, because I do believe Kenny is taller, then he's going to struggle a lot. I feel like AT will struggle in this fight. You know? You know, this ain't too bad. It's not too bad. But it's just... will we get a dirty boxer, or will we get something new from AT? And I feel like we will get what we saw in the Salt Pappy fight, where it wasn't the fact that Salt Pappy was bad, it's the fact that Salt Pappy couldn't do anything due to what Anthony Taylor was doing. You know, we still don't exactly know where any of these guys really rank. Like, Jake Paul, we know he can't beat Tommy Fury, so you rank him below Vidal Riley. You rank him below a lot of the high rankers, or below rankers. That does sound bad, I know, I'm sorry. But you'd rank him below on, like, ranking scale. You'd rank him quite low. Now, Salt Pappy, KSI, Logan Paul, none of these guys have really done anything to be like, you deserve that spot. You, if you were actually a boxer, you'd rank it. Obviously, it's not about that. That's not what they're doing it. But it's just, we need to tell where they are at. And in the pro, in the influencer scene, their ranking is Jake Paul, KSI, Logan Paul. That ranking is outrageously fucking stupid. It doesn't go Jake Paul, KSI, Logan Paul. It goes Jake or KSI at the top. Logan is nowhere near the top of that list. Logan hasn't won a fight, right? If we're going pound for pound rankings of their weight class, Logan is not at the top. Logan doesn't come near the top because, oh, he's athletic, he's big, he's so good. We haven't seen it. As good and as athletic as he is, it doesn't mean anything. We've seen that. KSI has proven athletic doesn't mean anything. It's who has that work set, the mindset, like JJ. That's why I believe, obviously, JJ is champ, right? JJ is the champ. In Misfits, he's the champion. So if we're going Misfits, it goes KSI, champ, Jake Paul, number one. Because the contender who should fight for the belt, or fight something like that, would be Jake Paul. Under that, you'd have whoever else is in their weight class. If Jake fights in another weight class, Jake will become unranked for a while until he starts beating guys. You know? I'm trying to base it off a UFC ranking system. People will be like, oh my god, you shouldn't do that. No, you should. A UFC, an MMA ranking system, is probably the best ranking system I've ever seen out of any of other boxing ranking systems, because there's too many organizations, promotions to have. You should have one organization that ranks everyone, right? Obviously, MMA has multiple as well. They have the PFL, they've got UFC, they've got Bellator, Cage Fire, Cage Warriors, all that, yeah? But Cage Warriors comes under UFC. But if you look at their pound-for-pound list, their rankings, it doesn't go down to, like, 400. It doesn't go to 46. It goes from champ 1 to 15, which is what I feel they should do. And everyone else in that ranking system should be unranked until they beat some of the top guys, which means that a lot of guys who are unranked need to work a lot harder. So, yes, what am I waffling on about? No, I get it. I know I'm waffling on about. But it's just the fact that, you know, we don't really know where any of the guys in the scene are. Like, we can sit there and be like, Salt Pappy's so good from what he's done to certain influencers. Josh Bruckner, you would have ranked him quite high. You know, he hasn't fought any of the top guys, but from what we've seen, he'd be quite high in the rankings, right? I'd probably put him around, I mean, what was that, cruiserweight? So he'd be, what, KSI's cruiserweight, Jake's cruiserweight, and Logan's cruiserweight? I'm probably wrong about that. But you'd stick Bruckner around 4. Salt Pappy beat him. Salt Pappy's number 3. AT beat him. AT's number 2. That's what I'm getting at. I mean, I'm probably not right about that, but I will go through, I'll make my own, like, pound-for-pound ranking list at some point. But let's get back to the training.
Let's jump straight back onto that JJ fight, then. You said it'll be a big statement if he gets
I mean, do I need to say more? I've already said what Anthony Taylor needs to do, you know? But it's very interesting. We'll see on the pads this week, what he does. I'll either stream it or I'll record like clips, and we'll see. But I want to know what you guys think. I want to know who you think wins. I want to know how you think they win. I want to know what someone has to do for them to win. You know, does Anthony Taylor have to fight to beat Kenny? Or is Kenny going to have to fight to beat AT? You know, I feel like AT's going to fight. So I don't want to see Kenny box. Because if Kenny can't outbox him, then he's going to struggle. But he has got Daly Price in his corner. And Daly is actually a pretty good coach. And I believe Daly understands that AT is going to be a bit of a dirty fighter. So I believe, you know what, screw it. Here it is. Here's my kind of prediction. I feel like AT is going to come in there and fight. I feel like Kenny's going to come in there and he's going to box. And I feel like AT is going to win a few rounds. But then they're going to, like, maybe like round one or two. Like, maybe those two rounds, if that. And I feel like they're going to be like, okay, this is how he's fighting. And then they're going to completely just be like, all right, that's how we've got to fight. And then they'll start obliterating Anthony Taylor. And I think Kenny does get it done. By stoppage, I don't know. That one, I don't know. But, you know, Anthony Taylor doesn't stop anyone. I haven't seen him stop anyone. I'm probably forgetting something. I am so sleepy right now. But Kenny has stopped a lot of people. And I think if it goes Kenny's way, this fight goes by stoppage. And that will lead into King Kenny versus Salt Pappy. Ashley Raksu said he wants to fight Salt Pappy. You can tell as well by the way he was like, I didn't outdo Salt Pappy's performance against Halal Ham. Halal Ham's got a chin on him, to be fair. But yeah, that's all I've got, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. It's so early. I'm going to edit this video. I'm going to chill. Fuck knows what I'm going to do. I'm going to chill. I'm going to relax. I'm going to get this video out to you guys. And yeah, let me know what you guys think. Let me know who you think is going to win. And yeah, we will bring some new stuff to the channel very shortly. Very, very shortly. Hopefully today. But guys, hope you enjoyed. I'll catch you in a bit. Peace out, everyone.